I personally value your art, and it is most important that when you post your photos on Instagram, there shouldn't be any cropping, there shouldn't be any white lines or resizing. So today we'll be learning how to do all of that without cropping your photos and post as it is on Instagram. We all know DSLR clicks either 3x2 or 16x9 or different aspect ratio, but Instagram only accepts 4x5 whenever you click something, a portrait photos, right? So being a portrait photographer, I know that we mostly click photos maybe 3x2 or maybe 16x9, but then that has to be in a portrait mode, and definitely you will have to tweak your DSLR and then click photos. But whenever you post something in Instagram, it only accepts 4x5, which impacts your entire photo, and you need to end up posting photos which is either cropped or adding white lines. So today we'll learn in Photoshop how to fix that problem and how you make sure that every time you post photos on Instagram are actually covering the all around and meeting the 4x5 aspect ratio. Right, at first we will open the Photoshop app, and I will show you in two ways. One is how do we edit. I will show a few examples now. I will quickly go ahead and open one of the photos which I have selected for you guys. Now in this photo, you see that this is not a 4x5 format. So to edit 4x5 format, you need to go to the cropping option in Instagram, which is a crop tool. So let me just go back and click the crop tool. So over the right top, let me just get away from this one. Over the right top, you have 1x1, 4x5, 5x7, 2x3, and 16x9. Now you need to select 4x5 aspect ratio, and once you select, you will see this is already done cropping. Now if you can directly crop like this and send, but then there is no difference you're cropping here in Photoshop or in Instagram, right? So you need to correct accordingly. So what I will do, there are two ways of doing it. First, I will do it with this photo. Now this is a studio photo. Now where what happened here is that the background is completely plain. The challenge is only when you were shooting outdoors, because you have many things around and you cannot use this method for that. So I will divide them into two methods. The first method is completely when the background is plain, where there is nothing in background, and you can definitely play with that. So what I would do is that I would extend it to end and towards the end as well. Make sure the content aware is checked over here. Now once content aware is checked, the Photoshop itself understand that it need to extend the part where it is white, right? So if you see, currently it looks like as if it's white. All you have to do is click somewhere out of the cropping, and the Photoshop start analyzing and completely change the backdrop. Now this is not always perfect, but eventually we got the perfect. So this you can directly export it and download into Instagram. If you see towards the edges, there are some problem. So you can actually tweak different ways. Now I'll show you how we can do. Again, I'll go cropping, and what I'll do this time, I will select both the ends. Now since there was some few problem at the end, so I will go ahead and select like this, and I will just go back and cropping, and let's see what Photoshop does this time, right? See, the Photoshop does the work perfectly. Now you can post this video. There is no stretching, there is no resizing, anything. You got the entire photo as it is. You clicked on Instagram, sorry, on your DSLR, and you can post it on Instagram. Now this is one of the example. Now I'll show you what happens when you actually have to click, do something when you take photos outdoor. Now that's the challenging, because you have trees, you have curtains, you have many things around. Now how do you stretch it? How do you make sure that it fits Instagram 4x5? Now let's go ahead and open the next image. I have selected this image for you. Now you see, you'll have to click on cropping, and once you click on cropping, you will have something like this. Now Here you have to make sure the content aware is not checked, because content aware is not going to do a good job when there are so many things at the backdrop. Now in this image, you see there's a frame at the backdrop. There's a itself, the subject itself is over here. So it is most important that you crop in a such a way that, I mean not crop, resize into 4x5 without losing all of that. So what we do is that I have unchecked the content aware option, and I will go ahead and increase the size of this, so the making sure that I don't lose anything which I clicked from DSLR. I don't have to crop, because I myself believe in framing, and I frame on DSLR itself. I don't want to come back to home and crop just because I want to meet Instagram 4x5. So once you click like this, you will have white lines around it. Now you have to use some other tool. You have to use selection, this rectangular tool. Let me just get rid of this. You have to select rectangular tool and making sure that you select the area where subject is not being touched. So I have selected something like this. Right. Now you'll have to go to edit option and go to transform and select distort. Now once you click distort, you can extend this part and you will see you can hit command D to deselect. Let's go ahead, sorry. Deselect, and you will see that the image has been extended. I will again go to rectangular and select this side as well. I did not select properly, but you will have to make sure that you select from on top end to right end correctly. And again, go to edit and go to transform and select distort. Once select distort, you can extend this and you can come back here and do command D to deselect. Now you see that I have extended the image and nobody can guess it that this has been resized from the edge. You see, I can go, even the photo frame is not being resized. Even the hand over here, it's looking perfectly fine. Now this is the second method when you actually shoot outdoor and you have multiple things in backdrop. That's when you can go ahead and edit like this, and you're making sure that whenever you post this, when you export this, it will be 4x5 and you can post on Instagram without cropping, without resizing and without white lines. That's it guys. Today we have learned how to fix Instagram aspect ratio. You definitely do not fix Instagram aspect ratio. You create a size which fits Instagram aspect ratio 4x5 and without losing your entire frame. Now, thank you very much. If you have any more method, if you have any more suggestion, you can definitely put in the comment and let other people know as well how they can do these things better from a different way. This is the way which we do from Photoshop. There may be people who are actually working on Snapseed or Lightroom. I don't know how to do that, but then in Photoshop, it's pretty simple, and make sure that every photo you upload is as per the Instagram aspect ratio 4x5. Thank you guys. Have a great day.